morning. It's wonderful to see those of you who are here, and hello to those in the parking lot who are listening. As you can plainly see and hear, I am not Pastor Kyle. He is away today, and so I am here to try to see us through the service. I will try to do the best I can. We have a few announcements today. It's with a sad heart that I inform you that our friend Al Paulus passed away last Monday. Our prayers and sympathy go to his family. I don't know about services for him at this time. There will be no Bible study on Wednesday as Pastor is away. And I got a call from Gretchen Takkinen yesterday, who is our parish nurse, and we are making plans for Trinity to be a COVID vaccination site. As of this time, we don't really know when, but plans are being made for when the vaccines do arrive in our area. So Gretchen has volunteered with Douglas County to give inoculations, and she wanted me to announce this in case if there's other nurses that would be available to help give inoculations. We would like to reach out to Gretchen and let her know that. Also, we will probably need a few volunteers to help with the logistics of having the site here. So if you are willing to be a volunteer for that, also we would want to let Gretchen know that. So if you are interested, you can see me. I'll also leave information with Jane in the office, and she'll have Gretchen's phone number to reach out to her. So please don't call about getting inoculations, however. We don't know who will be able to get these first vaccines, and we don't know when, so we don't really have any of that information yet. I'm told you can look on Douglas County Health website and it kind of lists who gets vaccines first, so maybe that will be helpful, but we don't have any of that information yet. But we look forward to that coming here, and hopefully sooner than later. Are there any announcements from the congregation? All right then, let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you, all God, in word and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your law and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you, and for his sake God forgives you all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gathering hymn is I, the Lord, See in Sky.
I'm
comes from you alone. Send us as peacemakers and witnesses to your kingdom, and fill our hearts with joy in your promises of salvation. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
See, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli, and said, "Here I am, for you have called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now, Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again, a third time, and he got up and went to Eli, and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore, Eli said to Samuel, "Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went down and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Then the Lord said to Samuel, "See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make both ears of anyone who hears of it tingle. On that day I will fulfill against Eli all that I have spoken concerning his house from beginning to end. For I have told him that I am about to punish his house forever, for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God, and he did not restrain them. Therefore, I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be expiated by a sacrifice or offering forever." Samuel lay there until morning, that he opened the doors of the house of the Lord. Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli, but Eli called Samuel and said, "Samuel, my son." He said, "Here I am." Eli said, "Oh, excuse me." Then he opened the house of the Lord. Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli, but Eli called Samuel and said, "Samuel, my son." He said, "Here I am." Eli said, "What was it that he told you? Do not hide it from me. May God do so to you and more also, if you hide anything from me, all that he told you." So Samuel told him everything and hid nothing from him. Then he said, "It is the Lord. Let him do what seems good to him." As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all of Israel, from Dan to Beersheba, knew that Samuel was a trustworthy prophet of the Lord. Here ends the first reading. The second reading is from 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter. "All things are lawful for me, but not all things are beneficial. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food. And God will destroy both and the other. The body is not meant for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? Should I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. Do you not know that whoever is united to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it is said, the two shall be one flesh. But anyone united to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Shun fornication. Every sin that a person commits is outside the body, but the fornicator sins against the body itself. Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Lord, Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. Here ends the second reading.
The gospel lesson for today is from John, the first chapter. Just a little bit of background, if I might. Jesus is 30 years old, we believe, because that's when Jewish men started their ministry. And that's what Jesus is doing, just beginning his ministry. He has been baptized by John the Baptist, and now he begins to call his disciples. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under a fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." Here ends the gospel for today. Now, Pastor may not be with us physically, but he is going to be with us for the sermon today, which he has recorded.
One second.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. As I'm sure you've already noticed, I am not among you this morning because I have been called for this particular time and place to a little bit different ministry. Not that this ministry is greater than the one I'm called to serve with you, but because God in his time and in his place sets work before us and a call we have to answer. I would like to thank you for the opportunity to serve in this different way, and also for the fact that I truly believe that you serve with me in this ministry. Because of your generosity of spirit, I am able to leave you for a time, but my hope and my prayer is that I will return to you directly, and I look forward to that moment. Interestingly enough, the gospel lesson we hear this morning is about a call that comes to serve. And that call is given to Philip and to Nathanael. Philip, quite simply, hears Jesus say, "Follow me," and does so. And through Philip's mission and ministry, Nathanael is called to the gospel. says to Philip, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Now, Nathanael was probably not so agreeable as Philip, because what Nathanael said was, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Nathanael, by his very nature, doubts that the very Son of God could come from this place and in this time to be the King of Israel. Interestingly enough, what is it that Philip says to Nathanael? He says, quite simply, "Come and see." The reason, my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, that we gather each and every Sunday morning here at Trinity Lutheran is for the same opportunity. Because Christ calls us to gather together, to hear his word, to share his supper, and to come and see what it is that Christ has done. That, too, presents us with both an opportunity and an obligation. Because each of us, and all of us, are called to invite others with the same words. Come and see what it is that God has done and continues to do in our midst. Evangelism. The thought, the word, and the action of calling other people to look, to see what it is that God has done through this Christ Jesus is our sublime privilege. And yes, indeed, even though Nathanael doubted that anything good could come out of Nazareth or any place like it, still indeed he went. And when he approached Jesus, what Jesus did is tell not who Jesus is, but rather who Nathanael is. And he does the same for us. Jesus looks in our hearts, looks in our minds, and indeed even looks at our soul and knows who we are. And even so, Christ not only approaches us, but dies for us, so that we might fully and finally belong to him. Nathanael's response to Jesus saying who he is a proclamation about who Jesus is. And he says, "You are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." And yet Jesus says, "You ain't seen nothing yet." And for you and I, the final culmination of God's love for us in the cross of Jesus Christ is the final fulfillment of how much truly God loves us and how much he binds us together. And so,
Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, give us the strength we need to follow you daily and to serve you with boldness and joy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, please be with those who are hurting today, those who are isolated and lonely, those who are mourning, those who are anxious or fearful. Please send them your comfort. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are ill. We pray for healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our country. During these troubling times, we pray that we might find a way to work together, find common ground, and show respect for each other. Please bless our leaders with wisdom and strength and courage. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who serve in our military, especially those who may be in harm's way. Please watch over them, give them strength and courage, and may they feel your presence and your peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let's pray our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our sending song is Songs of Thanks, Thankfulness, and Praise.